So a popular question that I get asked quite often is, how do I learn data science? What courses can I take to learn data science? And so I figured out that it would probably be a great idea to start a new series on resources for learning data science. And so this will represent the first episode. And without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so in this first episode of Resources for Learning Data Science, I will be covering about Kaggle Micro-Courses. So you might know of Kaggle as a website where you could compete in competitions and apply your data science skills to win prizes. But aside from these competitions, Kaggle also provides very good micro-courses that you can take to jumpstart your data science education. And so what you want to do now is head over to kaggle.com. So type in K-A-G-G-L-E.com, and you want to click on the courses on the top menu bar. And so I'm going to provide you the link in the description of this video. Okay, so here we see that it is comprised of 14 micro-courses. And the first micro-course is Python, and the second is Introduction to Machine Learning. Okay, so this is the main page of the Kaggle micro courses. And so let's have a look at the list of courses that Kaggle has to offer. So the first one is Python, and here you will be learning the most important language for data science. And the second is Introduction to Machine Learning, and you'll be learning the core ideas in machine learning, and you'll also be given the chance to build your first model. The third course is Intermediate Machine Learning. You'll be learning how to handle missing values, non-numeric values, data leakage, and more. Your models will be more accurate and useful. And the fourth course is Data Visualization. So you're going to make great data visualization, and it is a great way to see the power of coding. And so the fifth course is Pandas. And here you'll be solving hands-on challenges to perfect your data manipulation skills. And the sixth course is Feature Engineering. And here you will be discovering the most effective way to improve your models. So features are essentially independent variables that are used to describe various characteristics of your data sample. It could be either qualitative or quantitative. And the seventh course is Deep Learning. And here you will be using TensorFlow to take machine learning to the next level, and your new skills will amaze you. And the eighth course here is Introduction to SQL, and you'll be learning SQL for working with databases, and you'll be using Google BigQuery to scale to massive data set. And the next course is Advanced SQL. So you'll be taking your SQL skills to the next level. And the next one is Geospatial Analysis. So you'll be creating interactive maps and discover patterns in geospatial data. And the next one is Microchallenges. So here you will be solving ultra short challenges to build and test your skill. And the next course is also very important, which is Machine Learning Explainability. So here you'll be extracting human understandable insights from any machine learning model. So the next course is Natural Language Processing. So here you will be learning to work with text data. And the last course of Kaggle is Introduction to Game AI and Reinforcement Learning. So here you will be building your own video game bots using classic algorithms and cutting-edge techniques. Okay, so these are the short description provided by Kaggle for the 14 micro courses. So let's have a brief look at the first one. Let's click on Python. Okay, so here are the name of the lessons, and followed by the tutorial and the exercises at the end of the tutorial. And on the right-hand panel, you will be seeing the progress percentage as you progress through the course. And so this first micro course on Python will help to prepare you and give you the fundamentals that you will need to progress to the next course, which includes Introduction to Machine Learning, Deep Learning, Pandas, SQL, and Game AI and Reinforcement Learning. So take this course as a prerequisite before you progress to the next one. So let's have a look at the contents of this first micro course on Python. So in the first lesson, Hello Python, it's a quick introduction to Python syntax, variable assignment, and numbers. The second lesson, Functions and Getting Help, is about calling functions and defining your own and using Python's built-in documentation. The third lesson will be on Booleans and conditionals. So you'll be using Booleans for branching logic. So the fourth lesson is is list. And here you'll be learning about lists and the things that you can do with them, which includes indexing, slicing, and mutating. The fifth lesson is loops and list comprehension. For and while loops, and the much loved Python feature, which is list comprehension. And lesson number six will be on strings and dictionaries. And so here you'll be working on strings and dictionaries, which are the two fundamental Python data types. And finally, in lesson number seven, you'll be working with external libraries. So you'll be importing, you'll learn about operator overloading, survival tips for venturing into the world of external libraries. Okay, and your course instructor is Colin Morris. Okay, and that's all for Python. Let's head on back. Let's have a look at introduction to machine learning. Okay, so lesson number one, you'll be learning about how models work, and it's going to be your first step if you're new to machine learning. Lesson number two, basic data exploration. So here you'll learn about how to load and understand your data. Lesson number three, you'll be building your first machine learning model. In lesson number four, you'll be validating your model by measuring the performance of your model so you can test and compare alternatives. In lesson five, you'll be learning about underfitting and overfitting. So these are the essential concepts of model building, and you'll be learning about how to fine-tune your model for better performance. So in lesson number six, you'll be learning about random forests, which is my favorite, and it is a tree-based learning approach. In lesson number seven is an exercise, and you're going to compete in a machine learning competition. And here you'll be entering the world of machine learning competition to keep improving and see your progress. Okay, so this is a great way to learn as well. So by joining the competition, you'll be able to learn from your mistakes, what went wrong and what went well for your machine learning model performance. And therefore you could find ways to improve your model performance. And so here is getting started with the Titanic dataset. So you're going to create your own Kaggle notebook to organize your work in competitions. Okay, so your instructor here is Dan Becker. Okay, and so let's head on back. All right, let's have a look at third course, Intermediate Machine Learning. So let's have a look. All right, so there are a total of seven lessons. And so the first lesson is the introduction. So it will be reviewing what you need for this micro course. The second lesson will be on missing values. So you'll be learning about missing value and how you can prepare for this common challenge in real data set. And so real data sets could be pretty dirty that requires a lot of data cleaning. Okay, so in the third lesson, you'll be learning about categorical variables. So there's a lot of non-numerical data out there. Here's how to use it for machine learning. So in the fourth lesson here is on pipelines, and it is a critical skill for deploying and even testing complex models with pre-processing. And the fifth lesson will be on cross-validation, and it's a better way to test your models. And lesson number six will be on XGBoost, and it is an accurate modeling technique for structured data. And lesson number seven will be on data leakage. And here you'll be learning about how to find and fix this problem, which will ruin your model in subtle ways. And the instructor for this course will be Alexis Cook. Okay, let's head over back. Let's have a look at data visualization. So here you'll be having a total of eight lessons. So in the first lesson, it will be Hello Seaborn. So it's going to be your first introduction to coding for data visualization. Lesson number two, you'll be learning about line charts, visualize trends over time. Lesson number three, bar charts and heat maps. So you're going to use color or length to compare categories in a data set. Lesson number four will be on scatter plots. So here you'll be leveraging the coordinate plane to explore relationships between variables. Lesson five will be on distributions. So you'll be learning about how to create histograms and density plots. In lesson number six, you'll be choosing plot types and custom styles. So here you'll be learning how to customize your charts and make them look great. And so in lesson number seven, it will be the final project. And so you'll practice for real-world application. In lesson number eight, you'll be learning about how to create your own notebooks. So how to put your new skills to use for your next personal or work project. So this is very important, learning how to create notebooks, Jupyter Notebooks, or Google Colab. All right, and so the instructor for this is also Alexis Cook. Let's head over back. All right, so the next one is Pandas. So Pandas will have a total of 6 lessons. So lesson number 1 will be creating, reading, and writing. So here the description says you can't work with data if you can't read it. So you have to get started here. Lesson number 2 will be on indexing, selecting, and assigning. So professional data scientists do this dozens of times a day, and you can too, right? Because selecting data, indexing, and assigning is some of the common tasks that we do. Okay, and lesson number 3, summary functions and maps. So you'll be learning how to extract insights from your data. Lesson 4, grouping and sorting. Scale up your level of insight. The more complex the data set, the more this matters. Lesson number 5, data types and missing values. Deal with the most common progress blocking problems. Lesson 6, renaming and combining. Data comes in from many sources. Help it all make sense together. And the instructor for this course will be Alexei Biluger. All right, and so let's head on back. And the next course would be feature engineering. So in feature engineering, there will be 4 lessons. The first will be baseline model. So you're going to be building a baseline model as a starting point for feature engineering, which you could use for comparison when you engineer a new feature. So lesson number 2, categorical encoding. There are many ways to encode categorical data for modeling. Some are pretty clever. Third lesson, feature generation. The frequently useful case where you can combine data from multiple roles into useful features. Feature selection. You can make a lot of features. Here's how to get the best set of features for your model. All right, and the instructor for this course is Matt Leonard. All right, let's head over back. And the next one is deep learning. So here there will be a total of 8 lessons. The first one is introduction to deep learning for computer vision, a quick overview of how models work on images. Second lesson, building models from convolutions, scale up from simple building blocks to models with beyond human capabilities. Lesson number 3, TensorFlow programming. Start writing code using TensorFlow and Keras. Lesson 4, transfer learning, a powerful technique to build highly accurate models even with limited data. Lesson 5, data augmentation. Learn a simple trick that effectively increases the amount of data available for model training. Lesson number 6, a deeper understanding of deep learning. How stochastic gradient descent and backpropagation train your deep learning model. Lesson number 7, deep learning from scratch. You'll be building models without transfer learning, especially important for uncommon image types. And lesson number 8, dropout and strides for larger models. Make your models faster and reduce overfitting. And the instructor for the course is Dan Becker. All right, let's head over back. So the next course is Introduction to SQL. And here there will be a total of 6 lessons. The first lesson will be getting started with SQL and BigQuery. So you'll be learning the workflow for handling big data sets with BigQuery and SQL. Lesson 2, select from and where, the foundational components for all SQL queries. Lesson number 3, group by, halving, and count. Get more interesting insights directly from your SQL queries. Lesson number 4, order by. Order your results to focus on the most important data for your use case. Lesson 5, as and with. Organize your query for better readability. This becomes especially important for complex queries. Lesson number 6, joining data. Combine data sources. Critical for almost all real-world data problems. So the instructor for the course is Rachel Tatman and Alexis Cook. All right, so let's head over back. The next one is Advanced SQL. So there will be 4 lessons here. Join and unions. Combine information from multiple tables. This is for lesson number 1. Lesson number 2, analytic functions. Perform complex calculation on group of rows. Lesson number 3, nested and repeated data. Learn to query complex data types in BigQuery. Lesson number 4, writing efficient queries. Write queries to run faster and use less data. And the instructor is Alexis Cook. Let's head over back. And the next one is geospatial analysis. And there are a total of 5 lessons here. The first will be your first map, getting started with plotting in GeoPandas. Lesson number 2, coordinate reference systems. It's pretty amazing that we can represent the Earth's surface in 2 dimensions. Lesson number 3, interactive maps. Learn how to make interactive heat maps, coral plate maps, and more. Lesson number 4, manipulating geospatial data. Find locations with just the name of a place and learn how to join data based on spatial relationships. Lesson 5, proximity analysis. Measure distance and explore neighboring points on a map. And your instructor will be Jessica Lee and Alexis Cook. Let's head over back. All right, so the next one is micro challenges. So here there will be 2 lessons. You'll be given a blackjack micro challenge. So test your logic and programming skills by building a better blackjack player. Lesson 2, airline price optimization micro challenge. Can you improve how airlines set ticket prices? And so these are exercises and the instructor is Dan Becker. All right, let's head over back. And the next one is machine learning explainability. So here there will be a total of 5 lessons. The first one, use cases for model insights. Why and when do you need insights? Lesson 2, permutation importance. What feature does your model think are important? Lesson 3, partial plots. How does each feature affect your predictions? Lesson 4, shape values. Understand individual predictions. Lesson 5, advanced uses of shape values. Aggregate shape values for even more detailed model insights. So the instructor is Dan Becker. Right, let's head over back. Natural language processing is the next one. So here there will be 3 lessons. The first one is introduction to natural language processing. The second lesson will be text classification. Combine machine learning with your newfound NLP skills. Lesson number 3, word vectors. Explore an idea that ushered in a new generation of NLP techniques. So your instructor are Dan Becker and Matt Leonard. All right, let's head over back. All right, and the last one is introduction to game AI and reinforcement learning. All right, and so here there are a total of 4 lessons. So lesson number 1, play the game. Write your first game playing agent. Lesson 2, one step look ahead. Make your agent smarter with a few simple changes. Lesson 3, end step look ahead. Use the Minimax algorithm to dramatically improve your agent. Lesson 4, deep reinforcement learning. Explore advanced technique for creating intelligent agents. And your instructor will be Alexis Cook. All right, and so that's all. There is a total of 14 micro courses. And so you could simply follow the order as detailed here by Kaggle. So the best thing about this Kaggle micro courses is that you don't have to pay anything and you could get started in learning data science for free. And so this is a great way to get started and I highly recommend it. And if you find value in this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't yet subscribed to the channel, please subscribe to the channel. And as always, the best way to learn data science is to do data science. And please enjoy the journey. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and share. And I'll see you in the next one. But in the meantime, please check out these videos.